Hello everyone. So in this session we'll complete the DNA fragment, DNA fingerprinting. So in the last session we studied the basic concepts of DNA, DNA fingerprinting, and then after that we studied about the satellite DNA, and after the satellite DNA we studied the mini satellites and the classification. That's classification which comes under the sat DNA, based on the ratio of purines and pyrimidines, based on the length of sequence, and also the based on the number of frequencies, so that sequences, the repetitive sequences. On all those bases we studied the classification of sat DNA. It means sat DNA means satellite DNA. It has been classified into many types, or it has groups. Out of all those, we have to study only two, that is mini and micro satellite. In mini satellite, it is used as VNTRs. VNTRs in sense variable number of tandem repeats, right? So the variable number of tandem repeats, what are these? The name itself saying, variable number, a different number of repetitive sequences, repetitive DNA sequences. So with on that basis, and also the sat DNA, what it is having a unique sequence, DNA sequence, which is present in every individual. 99.9% individuals will be having same DNA sequences, but here only 0.1 variation occur, that 0.1 variation seen in the satellite DNA, because of this reason each and every individual sat DNA is unique. It is considered as unique sequence. And after that we studied the methods of DNA fingerprinting. What are the methods? Method in sense, how to extract the DNA. After that, how to isolate all those, how to separate all those, in what cases DNA fingerprinting has been done. In the cases like in the case of disputes, or in the case of maternity or paternity issues, and also in the case of crime. So in all these cases, DNA fingerprinting has been done. The next thing is, first we were talking about the methods, right? In the DNA fingerprinting method, the first method, what we learned in the last session, the first is isolation of DNA from the cell. How to isolate the DNA from the cell? By dissolving the cell wall, by precipitating that DNA with the chilled ethanol, we have to take out the DNA. And the next is, those DNA will be like a long polymer chain will be present, and in the form of long chains the DNA strands will be. Those long strands should be cut into fragments. That was done by using REN enzyme. The REN enzyme, the full form of REN is restriction endonucleases. The restriction endonuclease is known as molecular scissor. The scissor, what it is doing, it is cutting the DNA strand into fragments. And then what we should do later, so we have the fragments. Those fragments should be dropped into the electrophoresis instrument. That electrophoresis instrument it will be containing the agarose gel, and after some time the DNA base pair they'll get separate. Okay, so those DNA separated DNA base pairs, after it separated on the agarose gel in the electrophoresis instrument, we have to do the blotting method. Blotting means what? Blotting in sense, just transferring the DNA fingerprints, DNA sequences on the nitrocellulose membrane or nylon membrane. The nylon membrane, it will get traced. If we place the nylon membrane onto that electrophoresis or agarose gel, the transformation or transferring of DNA fingerprints takes place. And then that method is known as blotting. And then hybridization of labeled VNTR probe. So that is the fifth step in the DNA fingerprinting. And then identifying the DNAs by using autoradiography. So autoradiography, it is a technique where we can easily make out the differences between the DNA fingerprints of one individual and another individual. So that this is the content you got missed in the last session, right? So now we are going to continue that part. Only a small part of the session got cut in the last session. That's why I'm repeating all the things. So after the autoradiography, so it will come to know, we can easily make out whose fingerprinting here, DNA fingerprints are going to match with that particular person in sense. For example, some scientists have gone to some crime scene. They have collected the sample in sense, any kind of hair follicle, any kind of means there the hair follicle and the blood sample or any damaged tissue, if it is a sensitive case like rape, the semen, these are the samples should collected from the crime scene. The DNA fragments should be separated on the electrophoresis. If we have any doubts, if we have any doubt on any person, we have to collect their samples, blood sample or anything else. We have to compare those DNA fingerprinting. We have to match it. So this is how the DNA fingerprinting will be, it should be done. And one more thing to say here, the DNA finger, according to your NCERT book, they have given one structure, a schematic representation of DNA fingerprinting. The DNA fingerprinting schematic representation, like one side they have given individual 1, individual 2, and the person's sample got from the crime scene, like that they have matched everything. And they lastly they have concluded, yes, this person's DNA base pair, it has been matched with the suspect 1 or suspect 2, like that they have concluded. Okay, so that diagram, remember that diagram I'm going to draw in the physical class, and I want to repeat all those things. That's why I'm going to draw that diagram in the class. So till this session we have done the molecular basis of inheritance right from the beginning. In sense, we have come across the structure of DNA, replication of DNA, and also we proved about how the DNA proved, this is the genetic material, it it is the material which is going to transfer from one generation to other generation. So that also has been done by doing two experiments, one is Oparin and Hershey's and Chase experiment. So after that we have come across the DNA replication, semi-conservative pathway, and transcription, translation, and lac operon concept, gene regulation, tRNA, the adapter molecule, and lac operon, and genetic code, salient features of genetic code, and at last, just now we finished the DNA fingerprinting. Remember, my dear students, this is the very important chapter. If you have completed reading this chapter, just go through it one more time, because it has more weightage, the board. And one more thing I must say in this session, before 15 days back, I gave some assignment, some questions to write, to repeat those questions for 2 mark. Only few of you have submitted that assignment. Most of you didn't submit it to me. But today, as a part of end of this session or end of this chapter, again I'm going to give some questions related to this chapter. This is the end of the chapter, no, that's why. So just complete it, and if you have any kind of doubt, just ask me. Okay, so just write it. I guess the last question was on the structure of transcription, right? So continuation of those questions are as follows. Okay, the next question is, write the salient features of genetic code. Salient features of genetic code, this is for 5 mark. And the next is, write differentiate between the tRNA and rRNA. Next, one more question based on the differences. Differentiate between repetitive DNA and satellite DNA. And few more questions I'll add with this. The next thing is, write a detailed account on lac operon. Detailed account on lac operon. Next question, why tRNA is also known as adapter molecule? With a neat label diagram, describe translation. And next question is, write the methods of DNA fingerprinting. The next question, salient features of Human Genome Project. That is for 5 mark. Okay. The next question, what are the goals of HGP? Write any 4 goals out of all those goals. Okay. After finishing all those, just submit it to me. Let me check how you have defined the answers and all. So hope you understood all these things and all. If you have any kind of doubt, please ask me. Thank you.